So I heard that going outside is like good for you and stuff. So I went outside so I could record videos, and there's this really loud cicada in the background. So whatever you hear in the background, that's probably a cicada. So we're going to talk about differential equations because, why not? So differential equations is pretty much anything with like a thingy like this in it, and then like blah 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 blah. Okay, so that's a differential equation. This is actually a second order differential equation. So whenever I do like this, what I really mean is dy dx. And since there's only one little doohickey on it, it's called a first order ODE. And when we say ODE, we mean ordinary differential equations. That's an ODE or DPQ for whatever. The reason we care about ordinary differential equations is they're also partial differential equations. And partial differential equations are like partial derivatives. So it'd be like partial y, partial x. And then somewhere else you'd have like partial y, partial t. And Schrödinger's equation is something involving like second order partial differential equations. So we're not going to talk about Schrödinger's equation here. This here would be like a d squared y dx squared. And this would be second order. Boy, you really can hear that little cicada go. So those are the basics of differential equations whenever we talk about them. So you'll hear people call them ODEs, DPQs. First order means there's one doohickey, and second order means there's two doohickeys. So the first thing that we usually do whenever we start playing around with ODEs is simply verifying solutions. And this is going to feel very, very much like Cal 2, probably, or something like that. So if we said something like, show that the circle equation solves this thing, like that. So if we say, show the first thing solves the second thing. All right, and you're like, well, I can do this because I can, take derivatives. And you're like, yay. So there's two different ways you can do this. You can either solve. So here's option one, is to solve for y. And this is probably the most straightforward one, just because it's not already solved for y. There's only two options, really, because the other option is not solving for y. But anyway, so if we solve for y, we get y squared equals a squared minus x squared, and then so y is equal to plus or minus the square root of a squared minus x squared. Okay, so the question might come up, well, do we use the plus or do we use the minus? I'm going to use the plus for the moment, and then in a minute I'm going to show you why it doesn't matter. But anyway, so let's start with the plusy part, and then we'll say that the derivative is going to be equal to, because remember this is the same thing as a squared minus x squared to the 1/2 power. So we take derivative, got 1/2 a squared minus x squared to the negative 1/2, and then we take the derivative of the thing that's inside it. So it's the derivative of the x minus x squared thing, so minus 2x to the first power. And we can simplify that a little bit more and make that be this thing, do-do-do-do-do, minus x over the square root thing, like that. So, beautiful. Got it? Great. Okay, so now we want to show that it actually solves this DPQ over here. That's actually rather straightforward, except you can't see it, so there we go. So what I want to do is I'm going to plug in for this part. I'm going to plug in what I have, which is minus x over the square root thingy. And then I want to know, is that equal to the right-hand side? So for the right-hand side, so basically for this, I plugged in this. And then on the right-hand side, I'm going to have negative x over y. And because I went the plus route, this is my y here. So I'm going to put that there. And I'll get a squared minus x squared. And you're like, whoa, it's the same thing. Craziness. Well, of course it is, because I said I was going to verify it. So that's pretty much what we're looking for in doing stuff like that, is just checking the left and the right. Now, if you say, well, what happened if I use the negative one? Well, clearly if I use the negative one, I would have had a negative sign here on the y prime side, or it would be kind of, well, positive, but whatever, because two minuses make positive, but then on the right, I'd also have a negative because I'd be using that negative. So even if I threw in a negative sign, it doesn't really make a big difference, so that's kind of nice. Okay, so I promised you a second option. Okay, so my second option is going to use, again, well, option two is I'm going to use implicit differentiation. And the only reason I'm really doing this is just because it's good practice. Differentiation. It's hard to spell and talk at the same time. So I had x squared, before I forget, oops, I had x squared plus y squared is equal to a squared, and then I had y equal, or y prime is equal to negative x over y. Beautiful, yay! Okay, so by implicit differentiation, if you remember, I'm going to say, well, I'm going to ddx both sides. Okay, so if I ddx the whole equation, I'm going to take the ddx of x squared, which is 2x, and then I'm going to take the ddx of y squared. Okay, and if you remember implicit differentiation, since, well, that's going to be 2y, but then since y is a function of x, I also have to say times y prime. Then on the right, so if you don't know what that is, go look up differentiation. If you do, fantastic, but just as a reminder, you have to do it. And again, you have to do this part here because y is a function of x. So that implicit differentiation part's really important. On the right, we assume a is a constant, so that's just going to be equal to 0. Okay, so I didn't actually do this before I started, but it'll be fine. So now if I actually want to solve for y prime, you can see, well, y prime is equal to negative 2x over 2y. So it's equal to negative x over y, and oopsie daisy, well, that was really easy. So I just did it that way. So that's kind of cool. Weird, no idea. That happened a lot more elegantly than I had expected. So that's kind of cool. That's generally what we mean when we say verify solutions of differential equations is doing stuff like that. So let's do just a couple of more for practice. All right. So here's one. And so verify that y equals x squared over 3 plus 1 over x. Verify that this solves xy prime plus y equals x squared. Okay? So my recommendation is that you pause the video, actually try this out on your own, see if you can figure it out. You probably don't, or you don't need to use implicit differentiation on this one because y is already isolated in the first part, but pause the video, see if you can do it, and come back. Well, we'll assume you did that. All right, now I'm going to y prime, so is equal to 2/3 x. Oh, and then a stupid thingy. Oh, gosh. Hold on. So y is equal to x squared over 3 plus x to the negative 1. That makes it easier for me to think. So y prime is 2/3 x, and then plus, pull the negative 1 out front, x to the minus 2. Remember, that's not the natural log thingy. It would be if I was integrating, but I'm differentiating. There's my puppy. My puppy says hi. All right, so I'm going to see if I can solve this equation. So for here, I'm going to plug in this. So I'm going to have x times 2/3 x minus 1 over x squared plus y. That is this. And then for y, I'm going to plug in this thingy. This thingy. X squared over 3 plus 1 over x. And I want to know, does that equal x squared? Like, well, probably, because, you know, why not? So I have 2/3 x squared minus 1 over x, because I can distribute like crazy. X squared over 3 plus 1 over x, does that equal x squared? No! This and this cancel out. 2/3 and 1/3 is 1, which is just x squared equals x squared. Yay! Alright, one more. Puta mas por la fiesta, because my Spanish is amazing. Because this is what I do on a Friday night for fun. Alright. One more. This one's fun because it's got exponentials in it. So I want to show that y equals a plus bx times e to the negative x plus 2x minus 4. Show that that solves, I'm going to run out of space, I think, y double prime plus 2y prime plus y equals 2x. Okay, so I want to show that this thing right here, show that that solves, oh, look at me go, solves that. Amazing? Okay, so again, pause the video, go figure this out. If you drop a negative or something like that, that's probably gonna ruin it, it's over, that's what happens. So be very, very conscientious. One of the things you gotta remember about Diffie Cubes, you gotta be super duper careful. You drop a plus sign, it's over. you accidentally integrate or do some kind of chain rule wrong or something like that, it's over. The biggest problems that people usually have are properly applying the chain rule and the product rule and stuff like that. So if you find that you're having a lot of trouble doing what we're doing now, you definitely want to go back and review some Cal 1 and Cal 2 before moving on. So if you haven't already finished this problem, like I said, make sure that you pause it and go from there. But I'm going to go ahead and take the differentiation of this. All right, so I'm going to do the first part. I'm going to differentiate the first part. So a plus bx is just b, and then times the second part. And then I'm going to add a plus bx times the differentiation of the second part. And the differentiation of the second part is minus e to the minus x, right? Because it's, you know, the chain rule and stuff. All right. So I just did that so you could kind of see what was going on. Also to make sure that I didn't do anything stupid. And then plus 2. Then I'm going to take a second derivative. Y double prime equals. All right. So I've got negative b, e to the negative x. And then I got to do this double thingy again. So I'm going to take the derivative of that. And that's going to be b times minus e to the minus x. And then I'm going to say a plus bx times the derivative of this thing, which is plus e to the minus x, because it's minus a minus. And then the 2 goes off to nowhere. Okay, so now I just want to plug it into my original equation up here and see what I get. So I'm going to plug in the y double prime first. So this, oh, neat. And like that. And then plus 2y, so, or 2y prime, 2y prime my kitty wants to help. And then plus y, which is still a disaster. And I want to know, does that equal to x? And the answer is, well, probably. I'm just going to take a little bit of algebra to find out. Okay, so I've got minus 2bx, 2b e to the minus x, plus, I don't know, this is just a lot, a e to the minus x plus bx e to the minus x. So this is, you just gotta want it, you know? Just gotta want it. 2b e to the minus x plus minus 2a e to the minus x minus 2bx e to the minus x plus 4 plus a e to the minus x. Probably don't have to do all this, but that's probably how you did it. Maybe. Maybe you're brilliant. Maybe you did it much, much faster. And then why is this stupid person taking forever to do this? Alright. And then, 2bx goes to 2bx, and, plus this, minus 2 of that, plus 1 more goes to 0. And then, plus 1 of these, minus 2 of these, plus 1 again is 0. The 4s, and the 4s go away, and indeed I end up with 2x is equal to 2x. So that's pretty awesome. So generally, the solution to ODE problems are usually kind of the first ones that you play around with just to kind of get some exposure and help you remember all these goofy rules. So again, if you had trouble with any of this stuff, make sure that you're reviewing the chain rule, the product rule, differentiation, that kind of stuff.